Okay, so here we are. And you ask the question, and then I'll just go right back to you.
Sounds good. Take a little step forward. There you go.
Okay.
All right, so, you know, the UN was willing to screen this film, and they were willing to endorse it, and then all of a sudden they're bowing out. Talk about what you think the UN involvement in our country and also in the global stratosphere and the climate and rainforest specifically, whose side are they on?
As you've heard before, the United Nations had screened this film and or the early footage and had approved of it, and then they seemed to bow out all of a sudden. Well, here's what I've got to say about the United Nations. If you are the United Nations, freaking act like it, okay? We need to come together to solve this problem. Everything is connected. You've got rainforests that are helping out with the carbon dioxide that's killing us, that we are emitting on a daily basis that is just mind-boggling. It's killing us. And then when we take and we slash the rainforest like this, I mean, it's killing us quicker. You're the United Nations. Please get all the nations together on the same page. There's all the data. It's all there. Everybody can see it. We don't need to screw around with this. This is really urgent. And if nobody can see how they're all connected, again, that app that I told you about shows you at jpl.nasa.gov, Earth Now. I mean, it is really, you can see how everything's connected. How, it, you know, one thing that I took away from that rocket scientist on the plane back was that there are no boundaries, really, with regards to nations. We can think that there are, right? But when a volcano explodes or carbon dioxide emits throughout the planet, do you think it says, oh, North Carolina, can I cross over into your border? Or China, can I go into yours? No, it doesn't give a crap because it just spreads. And what do we do about it? We slowly die. Our air dies. We're killing off the rainforest. And, you know, the rainforests are the key to the future. Number one, they're going to give us the oxygen that we need. They're going to remove the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere that we need to breathe. And that's not even talking about some of the other things I haven't even figured out yet. They're going in and they're finding like little plants that, oh, by the way, the side effect of this strange little plant that we found that we just trampled over with a tractor, oh, that cures leukemia. Are you kidding me? These things should be treated as special resources. Precious resources, because we don't even know what they have. We don't know what they have to offer. We don't know what wonderful things, the things that we think we know about, we don't know crap. We really don't. We need to save the rainforest. We need to explore the rainforest. We need to come together as all nations under the United Nations. It makes me wonder what that organization is really doing. If this is not one of the most important things on its agenda, then what are they doing? What are they worried about? Nintendo? Their Jaguars? Their gold palaces? It's crazy. This is our planet. We only got one shot. We should make it the best.
Look in the small slot camera and say, whose side are you on?
United Nations? Or about the United? Okay.
And then do it about anybody.
Okay. As a species, you got to ask yourself one question. It's like the Clint... No, sorry. As a species, you've got to ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Like Clint Eastwood would say, whose side are you on? Are you on our side? Or are you on your own selfish side? Are you on the side of, you know, having a planet that sustains us and your children's children? Or are you about, sorry, I blew you out of the fucking
one. All right, we're going on. Whose side are you on?
Okay, let's see. That here, I can hear that on the sound, Kurt.
Yeah, we can
hear the headpiece, Kurt.
I know you can't.
Oh, okay.
I know, but I still have to hear what she's saying because it's really important to the film. I apologize.
I got you.
Continue what you were saying. I walked on the set and it threw everything off. So what were you saying? Finish what you were saying, please. To you, please finish so we can get recording. Great. And find out our ETA. Thanks. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Okay, sir, I'm going to throw that down.
That's okay.
Okay, let's just dive in because I've got other people's
starting
to stack up. I apologize, but I
had to
fight. So we got a lot of stuff.
I know you do, and that's why I said I'll probably have more than I need to cut for my ready.
Okay, so now whose side are you on?
Yeah.
Okay, okay. To both? Okay, both? Okay. Let's see. Growing up, everybody had a favorite team. Basketball, soccer, baseball. Well, there's another team that I'd like to talk to you about. It's called the human race, okay? United Nations, be damned. Whose side are you on? Are you for the good team or are you for the bad team? You know, we can talk about conjecture and, you know, and ramble all day. At the end of the day, our planet's dying. There's things that we can do about it. There's things that you specifically can do about it. And all you gotta do is sign up, raise your hand. Don't run your water, run your water a little less when you're shaving. You know, don't have it. Shit, sorry about that. We're off on a tangent. I think we got the message across.
Yeah.
Right?
Okay. Just give me a one-off. Whose side are you on?
Okay. Yeah. Okay. So, whose side are you on? Are you on the side of the human race? Are you on the side of the United Nations? Are you on the side of our planet? Well.
I'm on the industrial race, man. I'm industrial over here.
Yeah. Well, if you're siding with the United Nations, well, it looks like they're siding against our planet. And that's not a good thing. Let's sign up for the human race. Let's sign up for the planet. I'm in.
Okay. So, what they don't want us to tell you, 5, maybe 10 years tops, your app tells us we're probably a lot closer to that 2 centigrade that if we hit, we go into meltdown. Extinction rates at record proportions that now your grandchildren, if they are here beyond 5 or 10 years, will be watching things in photos or videos because they don't exist anymore.
Yes.
What does extinction mean to you?
Think about it. Have you ever said goodbye to a loved one, somebody that you knew, and they're just not there anymore? Well, in moving forward, that's exactly where we're headed. It's not going to be in my time. And you know, I wish I could do more about that. If you don't think about yourself, think about your children. Think about your children's children. What are they going to do? What are they going to do when they are looking back on what used to be our world? And they say, gee, Daddy, what was that? Oh, that was a dolphin. Or what was that? That was a chimpanzee. Or those were dogs. Yeah, we ate all the dogs because there's no food left. And there's so much, I'm sorry. And guess who's next on the grill, little boy? You know, I'm just saying. It's a bleak reality. It's a stark reality. It is nuts. You can change all this. We can change all this. We just have to come together. It gets me angry to even think about such a thing. But at the end of the day, we can change our world. We can change our future. What are you going to do?
You're a tree hugger.
Hate trees. No, I love trees. Kidding. I had to throw it up there. Yeah, I'm a tree hugger. Why the heck shouldn't I be? I mean, I should probably high-five trees if I could. At the end of the day, I am trying to breathe. They are helping me out. What's not to love? We're doing slash and burn operations, not showing them any love. It seems like the United Nations isn't doing anything to stop that. In fact, they're kind of encouraging it. I don't know what else to say about that. I'm a tree hugger, and I'm pissed off.
Are you a forest hugger?
I'm a forest lover. I'm an equal opportunity lover, and forests.
Cool. So, the Charter of the UN, by the way, this is the 70th anniversary of the UN. Did you know that?
No.
Yeah. 2015 marks 70 years. That we've all been getting together to get along in New York City.
I hate the UN, actually.
So the UN Charter, as published as of this date of this taping right now in 2015, says that they help with environment, health, human and humanitarian interests, etc. And they were helping with the film for about a couple of weeks until they might have found out we might want to tell the truth about this and not candy coat it. Mm-hmm. How does it make you feel knowing that your world leaders, your forefathers.
And they always blame the younger generation. The kids screw it up, man. The riots, the races, all this. Mm-hmm. But it's the older generation that fucked it up for us. How do you feel about that? And how do you feel about the guys who are that older generation, that's maybe you and I, that are running the world today, that are still making those same dumbass decisions that greed is more important than error?
Let me tell you how this makes me feel. And, you know, quite frankly, I don't care what you feel right now. I've got to get this out. Everybody has to know about this. Listen, the United Nations, it's the 70th anniversary this year, I think in 2015. They're supposed to find ingenious ways for us all to all come together, protect our planet, move forward culturally, move forward as a civilization collectively. And the more that I'm looking at this, we're going backwards. I mean, there are so many things that we can do. We can work together to We can work together to collectively sustain.
Sustainability. Is that what you're looking for?
We can move together forward for a collective sustainability. And that's in everything that we do. Not just, our economy, our commerce. But this is, with regards to, if you're going to cut down a tree, plant another 5. If you're going to do this, do that. We've got to think for the future. And we're not. We're eating up this oxygen. We're eating up our planet at an alarming rate. The waters are rising. Everybody, the planet is dying off. Nobody seems to understand that. And we've got the data. We've got the footage to prove it. We've got people that know. I mean, there's people that are leading us. And what are they doing? I think they're leading us into oblivion. We elect these people into office. Well, in some countries that are tyrannical, maybe they just make themselves go into office. But here's the thing. We can change this. We have to take it seriously. Do you want to elect some chump into office who just doesn't give, a dang about your grandchildren or your children's children, and all he cares about is, he's got a Jaguar and Mercedes and a plush house? Nobody wants that. We need to be in touch with reality. We need to be in touch with our planet. We need to be in touch with ourselves. And if we don't do that, then we've already lost ourselves. It's not too late. We can do this.
For those naysayers, they would say, Robert, okay, I agree with you, the world's ending. But they're lying, there's nothing we can do. So let's just party. It's the end of time. Sodom and Gomorrah time all over again.
For the naysayers out there that say, the planet is going to heck, and guess what? We're going to party till it's 1999. Well, 1999 has passed. Let me tell you something. Our planet is a living organism, okay? And what's amazing is, if you think about the human body and the wonderful things it can do, like if you're a smoker, say you smoke for 5 years, and you're polluting your body, you're polluting your lungs, you're killing yourself. It's kind of like what we're doing to the planet. Isn't it amazing that if you stop smoking, the planet or your lungs will regenerate, will grow back stronger than before, and make things better? This is what we're talking about here. It's never too late, but we are really close, and we're on the brink. We've got to bring it back. We've got to get it back. And we need to tell those people to shut up. Thanks, Simon.
Well, sorry, but you gave me a couple of thoughts. We're going to come back to the thought. Remind me about those people who shut up. But before we do that, why don't you picture like the film opening with like a Rod Serling effect, where it's coming in from outer space, and you see the shot of Earth. It looks great. Mars. It looks great. Mm-hmm. And a monologue going on, and pictures of time starting to evolve, and then another shot where it's to Mars, the Gemini twins. Mm-hmm. You have the visual.
I got the visual.
Like that mind-boggling thing that I put up on one of the somewhere on the universe.
And then we pan out.
Kennedy piece and all the other stuff from ABC.
I'm gonna take a ship that turns on as they make that arc in the near future, and they turn back. They see two Mars. That's good. That's nice.
Which are the Gemini twins, mm-hmm. Earth and Mars. Mm-hmm.
unfortunately, we don't look like Mars yet.
Well, we're going because they're twins. But now we become Siamese twins because that speculation, maybe there used to be intelligent life there on Mars.
Mm-hmm. Maybe that was us. Maybe we came here and screwed up our planet. That's great.
So with that thought,
okay.
If you were being like your wildest Michael Winslow self, you know who Michael is, right?
Oh, yeah.
Michael used to work for me at CBS years ago. Around the same time he was doing those movies.
Yep.
Michael, where are you? I need you on set. Get your...
Thank you. Picture that in your mind for a minute.
Mm-hmm.
And I want every wild sound effect that comes out of your creature's mind okay. for as long as you can sustain any noise, mm-hmm. artifact, things that could sound like it was a cartoon playing in outer space.
Okay.
Your Scooby-Doos.
Mm-hmm.
Any character voice you've ever wanted to do on film,
okay.
this is your golden opportunity.
Okay.
Robert
okay.
Burton, Richard Burton's little, no, just kidding.
The close-up camera has 9 minutes of tape.
Okay. okay. And there's an alternate drive on that camera also.
Okay. You going to tell them to shut up?
I did.
Did you switch to the, are you recording on the USB drives are onto the hard drive on the camera, because collectively there's about 110 hours of footage.
I'm talking about this little camera?
Yeah, there's also another drive on that. There's two drives on that one.
I think I'm just recording on the...
on the camera
on
drive
the
or on the SIM?
I actually don't know.
Okay.
I'd have to... It looks like it's on A. It's saying A.
Okay, so if you run out, then you can switch over to the other drive.
Okay.
That's the point.
You got
and
it.
If we lose that in the middle, as long as this one never goes down, we got 110 hours you can shoot nonstop on this one.
Yeah. Okay.
Save for a week. So with okay. that
picture,
whole scenario, and I don't mind if there's background noise out there, because again, I'm going to be putting in like "Welcome to the Jungle" going off,
okay.
you know, "Rock Me Like a Fucking Hurricane."
Yep.
He didn't say that word. He had nothing to do with that thing the Catholic Church used to put on people's files.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay. Under Cardinal something or other.
Okay.
Edit a lot of this stuff. Don't let this out publicly unless I approve it.
Ready.
Clean all the shit up.
And on that note.
Every noise, every sound effect, everything. Let it rip as long as you want to go. Tell me when you're done.
Let's take a stroll down memory lane. Picture, if you will, a quaint rocket ship going through the atmosphere, outer space, and we arrive on a beautiful blue-green planet. Destination up ahead? Earth. And as we take our rocket ship and we kind of spin around out past the quasars, and we're coming back around, it takes some time to do that. And as we launch back in and we look back at the planet that we saw a couple hundred years ago, it's changed. It looks a lot like this red planet, like Mars. And we see two dead Gemini twin planets. Glistening in space for no one to see because there's no one there. Can you think of all the travesty that happened on those planets? What if the people on Mars screwed up their planet so bad that they had to go back in time and God said, here's another planet for you. Don't screw this one up or you're done. Nothing. Fuck, I lost that one. Sorry, I was going back.
I'm like, where are you going? All I asked were sound effects, character voices, and now you're doing a monologue.
I'm thinking,
is this a Tonight Show? Okay. Where are we going here? In a second, I'm waiting for it.
Exactly.
Going to drop.
I don't know what
to do.
I'm going to be like, here we go.
Was okay. that your Ramblin' Rose bit?
That was Ramblin' Rose bit.
What's your sound
now?
For fire?
Yeah, sounds of fire. Sounds of like a car taking off. Like the Toyota ad you did, you know, where I... We ended up in a toilet ad together with no idea we were going to be working together. He was blowing on pipe, and I was speaking with big pipe.
Exactly.
Okay. Need I say more?
Okay, and so...
Bring it on.
Okay.
Show me your effects, baby.
Okay. If we could go back in history and just listen to the sounds of the entertainment industry and their dying thoughts. Why, dude, something's like our planet's dead! God! Mr. Kraft? I don't think there's any more ocean. Squidward.
Go ghetto on me. Do some ghetto sounds. Give me jungle sounds. Come on. Bring it on. Bring out your inner giraffe.
Dead. That's what we're looking at.
Okay. A dead giraffe. That's a dead sound. What does dead sound like? Give me all your dead sounds.
Dead sounds like this. I'm on fire.
Okay.
That's awful.
You're being blown away by a hurricane. The sounds of a hurricane. A giant toilet flushing, which is the LA River into the ocean. Every day we're flushing millions of gallons of crap into our food in the ocean.
Give me a sound of
crap going to the ocean. Crap to, oh yeah, that sounded good.
Hold on, ready?
Yeah, you're a big whale. Here's Moby's dick.
Oh, a planet.
Yeah.
Let's see. Right, the ocean. Yeah. Hold on. Well, I can't do that. I can do this. Come on. I can do it like this.
Do that big one for me now. Big apocalyptic helicopters, war guns.
Yeah,
you're exhausted. I wore you out.
Okay.
Do you have any other tribal sounds? Jungle, parrots, birds, elephants, rhinoceroses.
They can do 1,000.
Crickets.
Nothing comes to mind.
You're done.
I'm just. Okay. I'm trying to think.
I wore you out.
Explore the planet, but
I need to bring in naked women.
Get some good stuff in there.
Small farm animals.
Small farm animals.
That would help. Porky pig. Oh, they do.
Kill the planet. So you want people to look at you and say, you're despicable. Because that's just what they. So here we go.
You do like Archie.
See you, what is it?
Impersonations. Archie Bunker, George Clinton.
Hey, just remember, kids. Hey, Charlie Sheen here. Can't is the cancer of happening. And that's what we got.
Because I can blend these all into the collage of mind crap going on in people's heads. I want it to be hitting from all surround sound speakers, different voices popping up.
Hey, what's going on? Charlie Sheen here. Let's talk about the planet. What planet? It's almost dead. We can save it. We can turn it around. But just remember, kids. Can't is the cancer of happening. Boy, and you guys are a cancerous sore. Good. There you go. We got some good stuff. I'm sorry about your ribs.
Yeah, the one right over there. Are we going to get some pictures with your loveliness?
Yes, absolutely. Right. And then I'll change into my other loveliness.
I think you gave us phenomenal stuff.
The monologue, I was more concerned about getting that app out there.
Well, that's why I wanted to get out of the way so you could go through it all, and then we can decide how we would cut it up. Plus, we could put that on the website.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Did
this asshole ever get a hold of you? I mean, he's really busy, so okay, I'm going to call him again.
Can you call him right now?
I will.
I can rush his ass over here.
1, 2, 3. Good ones. Okay.
Did we get some?
Yeah, we got that. And I got
one. Okay, that's the planet coming over. Let me call this.
Yeah, call him. And we'll see if the girl's
just kind of puts me out.